love communication. I love to teach, I love to speak, and I love to sing in church on Sundays. I love stringing words together in sentences until something becomes clear that wasn't before. My friend Chris was in a car accident his sophomore year of college. One snowy night, his car slid and hit a road sign. Chris is fully intellectually intact. However, the resulting injuries from that incident have left him with major impairments throughout his body, including the inability to open his mouth. His left arm and hand are paralyzed, and because of his blurred vision and lack of muscle control, Chris signs by slowly and painstakingly signing one letter of the alphabet at a time. It took me over a year to understand what he was saying. Lots of patience, many tears, but in the course of that year, I learned something I hadn't fully learned before. Communication is a gift. Hello, my name is Jenny Hill, and I'm the media specialist at St. Michael Elementary. I'm also in the final stages of pursuing both my doctorate and my principal's license at Bethel University. Last winter, around this time, I sent out a survey to all elementary school principals serving in the state of Minnesota because I wanted to explore your demographics and how that impacts your use of social media. Here's what I found out. There are 922 of you serving as public elementary school principals. 145 of you participated in my survey. Your average age is 48.8 years old, and over 70% of you have served for 10 years or less. This is significant because the one thing my survey found was that there's a negative relationship between years of service and social media use. Put another way, the longer you've served as an elementary school principal, the less likely you are to engage with these tools. This is of interest to me. You get it! Okay. Yes! Okay. It's of interest to me because often the heaviest users of Facebook are the average age of our students' parents. The good news is that 78.6% of you are already using these tools for many reasons. You're doing it to tell your school's story, to give announcements, to connect with parents. You are tweeting for the sake of professional development. Hashtag awesome. The conclusion of my dissertation also came at a concluding chapter of my life. My principal of 7 years, the only boss I ever had, my former fourth and fifth grade teacher, somebody that I look up to, respect, admired, mentored me, someone I miss, retired. About the same time, we had a change in our district's policy allowing us to post pictures of students on the internet as long as we give parents the option to opt out. As I speak, wireless internet access is being installed district-wide. A new principal has been hired, and this is his first year as head principal. True to my research, he is very interested in social media, and together we've gotten the ball rolling this year. Three things I've learned. Cameras. Many people are using their iPhone, but because internet access is still being installed, I found that the use of traditional cameras is still a good choice. Especially when we have events, it's nice to have multiple cameras from multiple angles so that we can capture the event and we can get it online quickly without the use of email. When capturing video, I'd like to use the Sony Bloggy because it's a digital video recorder with a built-in USB port. Collaboration. You cannot be in all places at all times capturing every moment of your school day, so it might be helpful for you to recruit someone to help you. It doesn't have to be your media specialist, but surely someone on your staff is a social media junkie. And finally, commitment. I am learning that good communication is a choice. And if we want to communicate well, we need to communicate consistently. That means multiple posts every week. This takes time and effort, but I believe it's worth it because in the end, it leads to a greater sense of connection. This has been most exemplified to me when I posted a picture of one of our students, and the mother immediately replied with, "That's my boy." Ultimately, I'm continuing to learn that communication is a gift. It strengthens the bond between home and school so that together we can build stronger partnerships in the educational process. Hello, my name is Jenny Hill, and this is the beginning of my journey towards social leadership. Thank you.